become precisely controlled. Then they become ice cubes after they're filled with water and put in the freezer. The ice will keep the thin tubing from buckling in the next process. With a lever, he bends the tube around a U-shape block.
She's attacking the tree.
As he works it into a U-shape, the tubing hardens. After the ice melts, he places the U-vent in a balling out die. He lubricates the tubing with oil and places a steel ball at the top of the tube and presses it down. He drops in smaller balls and they push the first larger ball in the U-tube. This stretches the inside of the tube, rounding it to the correct diameter. And then the ball exits at the other end. Now, he pieces the tube together and solders it the same way a plumber joins copper tubing. He adds a loop for the valve section. In total, brass trombone has 9 feet of tubing. Straightened, that's enough to reach from the floor to the ceiling. But of course, trombone makers are more interested in musical highs and lows. Finally, he solders a brace into place to add structural strength to one of the loops. A diamond-tipped tool engraves the company logo onto the trombone's bell stem. And a taut bumping wheel spins against the trombone player.
Fuzzy, what are you doing, Fuzz? What are you still doing in there, Fuzz Navel? Here's a little girl. There's a boy.
Was your one-way ticket to being the class nerd? Well, today, even if you need a